12:30 p.m.
Place, the edge of the forest. A soft breeze is blowing and you can see the golden yellow sun shining just above the horizon. Leaves are falling from the old oak tree near the river.
At curtain rise, Cece the deer is by the water's edge talking to Stacy the stingray.
Stacy, Stacy, my acceptance letter for pilot school came in the mail.
What did you say? You're going to pilot school? When did you sign up for that?
Why didn't you tell me?
Well, I didn't. Somebody recommended me. Isn't it great? Oh, I forgot. You don't want me to go to pilot school.
Maybe I can try to convince her not to go. If I know when she's leaving to go to pilot school, I might have time to convince her not to go.
What are you even listening, Stacy?
When are you leaving for pilot school?
In 3 days.
Okay. Do you want to have a sleepover one more time before you go?
Of course, that'll be so much. She may not remember.
No. I mean, she told me she was, starting a yoga class. She's very busy.
She is? I didn't know pigs could do yoga. Well then, see you tonight. Don't forget to bring that floatable chicken.
She said it was a very big deal.
I don't know if I should listen to my best friend or if I should do my own thing. Stacy was acting kind of weird today, like she wanted me to leave. I thought she didn't want me to leave.
I'm here for our sleepover!
Stacy, you were acting weird yesterday, like you wanted me to leave. I thought you were scared of me becoming a pilot because I might get scared and faint while I'm flying the plane. And now you want to spend time with me before I leave?
I brought the inflatable chicken. And tell me again why I told you that last week?
I'm terrified of heights, so you think I cannot fly.
See, you are afraid of heights. You think you can become a pilot and not hurt anyone, but I know you will hurt people. You are afraid of heights. Flying an airplane is not a good idea. I also have no idea how you're supposed to hold the steering wheel.
You're not your usual funny kind self, but you are still funny. What's wrong, Stacy?
Fine. I'll tell you. The truth is, I'm not afraid of you hurting others. Well, actually I am, but it's mostly about hurting yourself. I don't want to lose a friend again.
It's okay, Stacy. It's not your fault Cookie the Clownfish is dead. She was just swimming to the candy store in an underwater volcano eruption. There's nothing you could have done to save her. Stacy, I have an idea. You can come with me.
To pilot school?
No.
Let's talk about this later and just enjoy our sleepover.
I just had another idea. You can let me become a pilot, and in return, I can pay for you to go to doctor school.
No, I don't agree to that. I also have money saved up in the bank to pay for doctor school.
Wait, did you just say the bank? I thought the bank banned you after you pushed over that lady who asked if you could check her balance.
A different bank. Look at this ad in the newspaper. There's an opening in What's Up Doctor School.
No, you can't go. Please don't. You're afraid of needles, and if you become a doctor, you can hurt someone or yourself. You could end up in jail or the hospital. I really want you to be safe.
But being a doctor has been my life's dream. Please, let... Wait. Why is my fin being itchy and red?
What do you eat?
Oh, just some pie from your fridge. It's really good. But that doesn't explain my arm situation.
First, you stole my pie. Second, you're allergic to sugar.
What? You put sugar in this pie?
Isn't sugar in all pies? Also, don't worry, it'll wear off. I'm worried about you going to doctor school because it's dangerous too.
We both don't want each other to go, and we both think each other's dream is dangerous.
I agree. My family always told me that meaningful lives come from meaningful work. I think we should both have whatever jobs we want. I believe we can become a doctor.
And
get set, go.
Wait! Do you hear that?
Sounds like the crunching of dead leaves.
I think it's the hunters. This is terrifying. We should not just race each other, but we should run away. This is how terrified I felt when my dad was in when I was 3.
I think I just heard the hunter say, "Hey, you panther and wolf, come here! We want you as rugs as on our floors. We need to fight them. And it's been my dream to take them down since they skinned my mom."
Dax, we have to run away, and it's my greatest wish to stay safe so I don't end up like my dad. An old tattered rug in a poacher's RV.
No, Aurora, we have to fight. We must get revenge. No, or, well, what if I fight the poachers and you stay safe and pretend to be a statue?
No, I'll get found and poached. I'll give up. I'll get killed with you. Wait, we could fight the hunters and only if we get found we could hide and only if we get back and we fight the hunters.
That sounds okay, because you are always right.
You don't have to be sarcastic. I want to spend time with you while I can.
I feel the same way about you. You made me feel happy when I felt left out on the first day of school at Willow Wetland High.
Okay, on three, we run. 1, 2, 3. Here, let's hide inside this burnt green bush.
Aurora, do you think we'll make it to being...
Shh! The hunters said they're gonna find us and skin us.
Oh, no!
Yes, but this means life or death. We have to go. only home? Where will we live? Who will we play with?
But we can find out the details later. If we stay here, we're gonna die.
Details? Friends are not details. They're the most important thing in the world.
Well, in the ocean we can find Gary and Steelhead and Flip the Salmon. We haven't seen them since they moved there for more food.
No, Blue, I'm not leaving our home that we grew up in. I'd rather risk dying than leave this river.
I don't want to die. I'm leaving, with or without you.
Fine. Go ahead. Leave your brother behind. I don't care.
Fine. I will. I don't care either. Goodbye.
No, Blue. Stay with me. I can't take care of myself without you. I need you.
Fine. I won't leave. But we have to go together. You have no choice.
Why? I love our house. And our backyard full of green seaweed and plenty of shiners to snack on.
First Flat, we know we're running out of food in this river. There's not a lot of food here anymore. But in the ocean, there is a lot of horse-eyed jacks.
Oh, horse-eyed jacks are my favorite food.
I know we'll lose our river home and some friends. But we will find a new home, new friends,
Well, Mom always says, you win some, you lose some.
Don't forget the big win of not dying. Speaking of which, we gotta get moving.
Yes, let's go now before it's too late.
Selfish.
I guess I'm also being a little bit selfish. How about I let you stay with me for now, but soon you have to find or build a new one.
I promise I will! I was cooking my roaches and I had to get some more seasoning for them and I left the oven on, so that's why I caught a fire.
Well, now we know you always succeed when you work together. Oh, and if you need some help cooking, you could always ask Bud and Ramsey the Ram to help.
It's okay, I got two of them all, and I will tell you all their names. are always as loved as you will ever be, thing. What about it? Two things. Where did you learn it, and how did you know that I needed that?
Well, for the first thing, my mom and dad always told me that. And for the second, I don't know. I guess I just need you.
Okay. Well, it is a beautiful lesson.
You're right.
You better go find the hyena back. I think they will want to know what you have decided.
Okay. Well, then, bye for now.
Bye. Wait. When can I come visit you?
How about any time you want?
Okay. Goodbye, then.
And also, please remember, I will also be just the same amount and just the way you were.
I will.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Best chance. Is it okay if I have one?
Anyway, I'm getting older enough.
characterize it's a warm and breezy morning. Magnipo the lion is on his way to Malarian the tiger's house. Magnipo is a big and bold lion.
Malarian, Malarian, there's a world to it. You enjoy every type of meat. And within 1 hour and 15 minutes, I have to go. I will do anything to go.
Wait, what? No! You will not! You will stay here with me.
But I have to go. You have known for years that my greatest wish is to go on the world drive and have meat.
I know, but you're forgetting that we have all the meat here in Africa.
You are so very stubborn. We don't have moose, no panda bears, no kangaroos. We don't have grizzly bears or polar bears or penguins, no golden horses, frogs. There are so many more meats out there. There are so many meats that are not in Africa.
Yes, we do. We have hippo, giraffe, alligators, zebra, antelope, elephants, hyenas, gazelle, coyotes, bison, anteaters, rhino, wildebeest, lemurs, cheetahs, all kinds of meats.
Yes, but fine. I will run away and I will never return because you will never let me go.
What? No, 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 no. You stay here with me.
No, you have made me stay here my whole life. If you don't let me go, then I will kidnap you and drag you along with me.
Magnipo, I cannot allow you to do that. You know I'm stronger than you. And besides, I thought we were friends.
How about we go on to our trip together? And when we come back, we can stay home. Do you think that will work?
No, you threatened to kidnap me.
It's my only chance. I didn't actually mean it.
Let me think. No! I am set on no. You can't go.
Listen, I need to take this opportunity. Even if I'm scared to leave or don't know how, I at least try and give it my best.
You can't leave me alone in this place.
That's why I'm telling you to come with me.
Okay, Magnipo, but then I get first dibs on all that delicious mousse.
That's the idea.
Definitely not. Hmm. Well, work, I'm going to save little Kimmy now. And that's that.
I get that work. I'm also glad you did what Dad always says to do, which is...
I know. Don't be afraid to ask for help when you need it.
Well, what are you waiting for? Come on!
Oh, hey, wait for me!
Please, Marlai, that chance has come and may never come again.
even care about our friendship? You brought something up again, and I still don't think that's going to solve the problem. Whatever we do, we should work together. We're friends. We trust each other. I want to be friends with you, but I'm not sure you do.
You're right. Of course I care about our friendship. I just thought... Never mind. Maybe a compromise is in order. Maybe going our separate ways is working together.
What do you mean?
I stay here and defend the town, ready to fight if needed. You go gather representatives of all the surrounding towns and take them to the rival town's leader.
That's not a bad...
Oh, wait a minute. What's that smell?
It smells like smoke.
Why do we spend so much time arguing? What's burning?
I don't know. Whatever it is, it can't be good because it's coming from a direction of the town.
We should go check that out. Whatever it is, it might mean the town is in trouble. Oh, no. Maybe the rival town's attacking.
We need to build our plan fast. Let's go.
Right. Go round up as many representatives and residents as possible from wherever you can find them, even if it means traveling a little. I'll hold them back until you can come with help. And then we will not exactly fight, but protect ourselves and others while trying to stop them and try to not have that many people injured. We will have a peaceful end.
That's pretty good, but one little adjustment.
And what's this little adjustment you so dearly want?
That we're in this together, all of us, Swivels. Like I always say, kindness is the key to happiness. So if these towns both want to be happy, we have to be as kind as we can so they can be kind and happy with us.
You're right. I'm being too hard on myself, feeling like I'm not worth it, trying to rational things to prove I am, and trying to carry too much on my shoulders. Thank you. I do need help. Plus, you're right. Kindness is the key to happiness for both towns. Now let's go and get this done. The more we stand here, the worse it's going to get.
I don't believe you. You already have enough friends. Plus, yeah, hey, now it's coming home from school with me, not enough.
He said, you know I love you, but you're my brother, and I don't have any real friends. I am suffering, but I want to rest.
Well, I thought you'd run away when you stayed after school. I'm afraid you'll leave me. I want to stay here forever, and I don't want to come after you if you run away.
No, I just want to make a friend. I'm not going to leave you.
Well, You could go to a different school. That way you can make new friends and still come home right after school.
But it's the only way, it's the only school after the district.
But we could go to a new school.
But
we don't have the material. I guess you could move away and go to a different school.
No way. That is not happening. I want to stay with you.
Well, you could homeschool or do online school.
Because I won't
solve
my problem without having a
test. Oh, Jace, maybe we can figure something out.
Ethan, you've only been with me. Why can't you just go to the last day after this? I just want to make a friend with the teacher. I can tell you that this is a good one. Why would you say, don't you want me to just go to that after school? Think of a single lecture, remember? Is that what I'm going to do? Do I go to the
second? Okay, you got me there. Sorry for fighting with you. I'm sorry for not believing you and thinking you were lying.
That's right.
Hey, kid fang. Ebony fang. These hips. Smooth. And I have something for you.
Thanks for the sharing.
Quick. Go before after school closes, and I'll go back to the house. That's where you'll find me. Go! Take adventure!
Do you want to get kicked out of your pack?
But no! I don't want to leave.
try the new game pieces later.
Of course. I can't wait. Ooh, I can see an elk. I'm ready. Nibs, you ready? Jasper, Johnny, and Beepo, go to run back. Gumbo, go to the left. Tyler, Chocolate Cup Thunder, go to the right. Let's go. Trust the process. We can do this.
Yeah.
Fine. If you got this, I'll just tell you ideas. Maybe you can climb down
We are still on a cliff. Just grab that vine.
Fine. I'm only doing it because it's my only choice.
Well, okay, I may well take that risk.
Okay, could you please take my hand? I'm really worried. Maybe because you're dangling 500 feet in the air?
I'm glad you trusted me with my hand. Now we need a way to climb down.
What do you mean? Well, that's strange. The cliff fell in the exact same spot that I was in just a second ago. It's like we're in a dramatic play.
You're right. Are we in a play? Probably not. Nah. Anyways, how do we get down?
How about we slide down that vine? I bet that would work.
That would work.
Why are we 500 feet in the air? They thought you wanted people to live their best lives. Wait, do you think I took that too far?
You did take that too far!
Let's slide.
Finally, we got down.
Finally.
That took longer than expected.
I mean, that's not my fault.
I'm never going on a mountain again. What about you?
Never, ever again.
You're welcome.
Thank you for telling me. When in doubt, air it out.
You're welcome. I better help you get out of your comfort zone, too. Now let's get to rest.
And some food.
Sure.
and you better get your hand off my brother.
Don't make me do it myself. I am not going to let you go out in that thunderstorm. Why, you always want to have fun without recognizing that it's dangerous.
Autumn, the overpressured bunny, you are not going to just yell at me and tell so that I will listen to you. No way! She's on her world tour racing. She can run across. serious? That was last week. You need to get your timing accurate. Hey, we know it's long gone.
Here's the plan. Let's go,
John! No, I can't swim! That's why my name is Rock, because I sink like a rock in water.
We have to get you down there. It's the only way to survive the storm, and it's coming in an hour and a half. Let's think of some ways to make this work.
Can you hold on to me and fly me down there?
No way. You're heavier than I am. And besides, I can't fly in the water. I glide down and swim to the entrance.
We have to find a way or we are both toast. Ooh, that makes me want butter.
This is no time to be thinking about food. How else can we make this work? I think it's an opening in the top of the temple. Maybe that one will...
I saw some branches from old trees back there. Could we make a raft? Then I can float over. We can float over the temple, jump off, and then I will sink like a rock all the way to the bottom.
Perfect. That will work. But sir, we only have half an hour. Let's push the raft into the middle of the lake and jump and swim after me.
We're here. Now we can wait out the storm here.
Luckily, there's a giant trampoline in the third room to the right that will get us back to the surface.
I'm sorry for doubting you, Gus.
It's okay. Always be honest and adventurous.
You're right. I should have done that from the start. Boom! The storm is raging. But we're safe in our underwater temple.
I guess we have to wait here till the storm is over.
Then we go straight to the giant trampoline.
And we'll have to jump on a really hard rock so we can make it back to the surface.
I'm happy we figured this out together.
Me too.
Feel good.
if you want to go or not. I want to have fun.
But you're being very
picky and not wanting to go because you're afraid they'll tease you about being small. I've seen them before. And I know that you're about to drown.
They won't save you.
If there's an alligator in the river, they'll teach you the safest way up on high ground. If there's no high ground nearby and there's an alligator in the river, they'll teach you how to quickly dig a hole in the ground and be safe. If there's a big lightning storm, they'll teach you what to do to survive. They're the ones who taught me to make a dam like a beaver and be happy and safe and pretend I'm a beaver even though I'm an otter.
Okay, well, now I kind of believe you, but still, I don't want to be teased. How do I know that that's a picture? They need to draw it because I know that it's very dark and horrible. How am I supposed to know that you've had this experience?
Ask Mom. And by the way, you're great at art, much better than me.
I want to draw animals and pictures, but I can only draw designs. My art teacher was bad enough to teach me only designs when I was five. I'm still horrible after years of practice. I don't know what to do. I can't wait 10 years, and I can't go now.
Just realize that they won't tease you. Or at least realize that being teased isn't so bad. Let's go get packed. Please, just have some fun with me, and I'll catch a mushroom so you can try them.
Okay. Fine, let's hope they won't tease me, but if they do, I know I'll be okay. You only live once, so you better have a good life and fit everything into it. Maybe being teased is not so bad. Maybe this will be a good idea. Maybe. Wait, we don't need to pack anything. We're otters.
Scared to go to Paris. You can't careful there.
I will send you pictures.
Okay, so where are you going to go first?
I'm going to Hawaii first, and I heard that Hawaii has the best coffee. And you know much how you know how much I love coffee.
Yes, I do. When you come back, take some souvenirs and maybe some coffee.
Already ahead of you. See you soon. Bye.
The world is a good place and a bad place. Maybe I can come with you next year and try it out.
Sounds good. And I'll see you soon.
Loyal to others, but always respect their boundaries.
I was not looking for your name.
hashtag in the reach of the guardian host. Your cool, salty air is rushing up against your warm face as you can smell the strong, salty scent and almost taste it. The little drops of ocean that spray down the lake keep Clementine's feathers as lovely as fur cool and mint.
At curtain rise, Clementine the crow and Trebaverina the squirrel are having an argument outside of Clementine's house on a branch. Trebaverina just came over 5 seconds ago and knocked on the door.
Good morning, Trebaverina. Why so early?
Morning, Clementine. Something crazy just happened, and I need to tell you now. You know, I got that part for that movie that will likely get me to Squirrelywood. It's no longer in 9 months. I have to be there in 2 days.
2 days? That's too soon! And it means that you are going to Squirrelywood to just leave me. You know it's not fair for me, right? The reason we've had this conflict every day for forever is that my greatest fear is losing friends and family. And you leaving is losing friends and basically family for me. I'm worried that when you go, you're gonna forget all about me.
Not everything is about you, you know. I love being your friend, but I also want to follow my greatest wish and go to Squirrelywood. I want to be happy, and reaching my dreams will make me even more happy than I am now. Also, this is my dream, and this is probably my only chance to grab it. You're leaving for Crowledge eventually to get your degree in business, so you'd forget about me anyways. But that's the least of my worries.
I never forget about you.
Best friend I've ever had in forever.
Also, why am I the least of your worries?
I care so much about you, and I'm afraid you make so many friends and forget about me when you leave. And when you become famous, everyone will know you are.
Are you kidding me? I love the feeling of being on stage. I love the adrenaline. I'm done with this conflict. We've had the same argument every single day for 8 months.
I'm sorry, I know. Before I thought it'd be fun and I could find a way to stop you from going to Squirrelywood because there was a lot of time before you left. But now there's no time and I feel bad about trying to get in the way of your dreams. We need to talk about this before you decide to leave and come up with a solution. Why don't you just find a different movie that's next to you?
Because Squirrely Potter is my favorite book and movie series. And I remember reading it in my cozy tree where I was born in Moss Grove, Idaho. And now I finally get the chance to not only act in it, but be one of the leads. It's more likely that you'd call the directors and scream at them than me letting you ruin my chance.
Hey, that's not a bad idea. I could say something like, change it back to 9 months now, and I mean now!
It's a better idea than making me leave acting in my favorite series, but they would still fire me, so no.
Is she serious? I guess since I have a scholarship for any college I want to go to, and I've not found one yet, I can find a college in Southern California so I can live near you. Until the school year starts, we can FaceTime every night.
Sounds good. I'm sorry I was so quick about leaving.
You're good. I should have gotten in your way, finally catching you. And it's okay if you make friends, as long as you're happy. Just please don't forget about me.
You never got in my way, and I will never forget about you. Also, there's a college in California called Crawford University. And it's one of the best colleges in the state of California.
Thanks. Good luck. And always remember, you must walk up the hill to see the view. My mom used to stay there all the time, and it means you have to work hard before you can see the best parts of life. Like now, if we didn't work on this hard-to-solve problem, we wouldn't be in a healthy relationship, and you wouldn't have the chance to reach your dream. Now that you have the chance, work hard and stay with it.
Thanks. I will remember that. And you should remember that, too.
Okay, good luck, and be safe. You know how careful and cautious I am.
I know.
Oh, and you better go buy those plane tickets, like now.
Oh, yeah. California, here we come!
Goes on by Russell Scott.
Venom, the snake, and his grandfather, Z. Achilles, the snake, grew up in the large oak tree where they live. They're fighting because Venom wants to go to his family, and Z. Achilles does not want him to go.
I have to go to my family. I just found out where they are with the squirrel. They're in Germany, but they're about to leave. I really want to go see them again, and I need to go right now before they leave Germany.
No, Venom. No, no, I don't want you to go. You're too young and not strong.
I have to go. You know my greatest wish is to go to my family and stay with them. They left me with you, and they moved 6 years ago, and I had to stay here with you. I thought it was too dangerous for me to live with them while they were trapped in the world. But I want to go. Now they're going to leave. I have to go right now. I am old enough and strong enough. You know our family motto is if you say you're going to do something, you do it to the best of your ability.
No. A hawk could come and take you, or a car could run you over. You're not fast enough to get away from them. You don't know anything about the cities or the dangers of the world. But I won't let you go. Why don't you stay with me? Till I die. Otherwise, I'll be all alone and I won't be able to see you again.
And do you have an idea? Because I'm going to Germany no matter what. Just come with me and I promise I'll stay with you.
No, I'm not going to go with you. I will get too tired of it. Try to go. I will trap you in a cage so you can't leave.
You can't trap me in a cage because I'm a skinny snake and I can fit through small spaces. Please come with me. Please come with me. I can make a magic carpet.
Prove that. Prove that you can do that because I don't think you can do that.
You're right. I can't do that. I just randomly thought of it. Just come with me and I will carry you on my back so you won't get too tired.
How do you do that? Oh, okay. I love you. You can try.
Thank you so much. I never thought you'd say yes.
How did you find out where they live?
From a squirrel named Squeal. He said he went to Germany and saw my family.
I don't always believe your friends. I know where your family actually lives, and it's not in Germany.
I wouldn't say that in the farm squirrel. It's right there at that tree.
I don't care about Squeal. I only care about you.
Then where is my family?
In Philadelphia. They had to move because their house was falling down. I guess you can go to your family now, too. I'll ride on your back. We can try to use your family motto.
Okay, let's go. My mom and dad told me when I was two. If you say you're going to do something, you do it to the best of your ability. And this trip may not be easy, but we can try to do this to the best of our ability.
You are so rude and selfish.
Me?
jealous thief.
I am not a thief or jealous, Spike. I just want you to be my friend forever. I want you to sail with me.
Maybe I should just give up on my dreams. Who wants to sail the pond with all this conflict? What's the fun in that?
Oh, please give me another chance. This sail is not very comfortable to drag around in my small pocket.
Ooh, Sloan, we could all go together. You are both my best friends, so if you want to come, you're coming with both of us. I promise it'll be fun, Sloan.
But I really want to go with you and only you. Oh, you know what? Fine. I'll go. But I'm not going to be happy about going with Clementine.
Thanks, Sloan.
Yeah.
Well, let's pack our bags, give Clementine and go.
All right.
Let's go. That was beyond fun. Like my family always says, have fun until you're done. After all, life is short.
Yeah, I have heard your family say that, Spike. And I love it. I guess life is too short to be jealous. Thanks for helping me see that, Spike. You're a really good friend.
You're very welcome, Sloan. Now let's go have fun.
Not filled with gold? If there tell the truth. You don't have to remember the lie.
What did you say? Did you say if you tell the truth, you don't have to remember the lie? What? What's that mean?
Yeah, that's what I said, because you said, I don't want you to be safe. But you would have never locked me up here in the first place if you didn't tell a lie. And still, no rock. And what I said, it means that if you don't tell a lie, you will never have to remember something you did wrong. It's hard to explain. And off topic, but Leah, how come you live a normal life and I'm locked in my burrow? I just want to live. I just want to fly. I let you do everything you want to do. And every time I want to do something, you say no. Why? Just let me out. I know that you do want me to be safe, and I appreciate that, but I need to live my own life.
I'm so sorry. I shouldn't have tied you down. And I just never let you have your dream. I want you to be safe. I was just scared that you would get hurt and maybe even get killed. I never let you do anything because I wanted you to be safe. I should have let you live a normal life. I was a fool to tie you down and keep you here in your own burrow. I'm still so sorry. I'll never lie to you again. I'll let you be free. I will keep what you said with me. If you tell the truth, you don't have to remember it a lot.
Thank you. And thank you again for listening to my words of wisdom. My words of wisdom! And I forgive you, Tia. But since you mentioned the cocoa cookies, I'll be right back with lots of cookies!
The end. Until Luna comes back with the cookies!